Before I start this video, I just want to say that I forgot to say that I will have a link down in the video description about the bug report, so please go on there, check it out, and I don't know if you can upload it or what system there is, but like, just check it out. So let's go on with the video then. Hello and welcome to my first bug report video, and yeah, basically this is some advanced stuff, so I want to send this to the bug report, and it's a pretty old bug which needs to be fixed because I tried to do something. I tried to make a little explanation, so maybe just stick around, but maybe I will also like somewhere down here will maybe stand is a timestamp where you can just skip after the explanation, but I think the explanation is important. So what I tried to do, I tried to create a data bag which transforms a normal horse into a zombie horse when you go into the Nether, and transforms it back to a normal horse when you go out of the Nether, because I just thought that would be a pretty neat little feature. So the problem with that, I want to show you, but like, it would have been pretty easy to make that before 1.11, because a zombie horse was just another variant of a normal horse. So I can demonstrate that, like, if you summon a horse, it's always like a horse, but if you would summon a zombie horse, it's not a variant anymore, it's now a zombie horse, so it is its own type. You pretty much should know it. Also, skeleton horse is pretty much the same. So yeah, what I did want to try to make is basically I wanted to store the variant of a horse into a scoreboard to later load it again, so that the horse keeps the original texture. So my plan was basically to go to the Nether, have its normal horse, summon a zombie horse there, and store the variant into the zombie horse, and then store it back again if you go to the overworld. So for people who don't know what the variant is, Minecraft always, there are like pretty many different horse textures. So if we would like, let's do that. If we would make this comment, you would see there are many horses with many different textures, but actually it's not like there are not that many horse textures. It's just like 4 to 5 different horses and just overlays which randomly would get picked by the game and then would get stored into a variant. So if we would summon a normal horse without a variant, it would always be a random horse, because it would always like, yeah, that's some unlucky accident, but you would see it's always like another horse. But if we would summon a horse with a variant tag, it would always be the same horse. So as you can see, it's always that horse. If we would change it to say something like 9, it would always be that horse. So you get the whole general idea. So what I tried to do, or basically what I did, is I created a scoreboard which is called horse variant, and stored basically so the second comment block is just for giving you tags so that it doesn't get spammed, but basically I stored the result, I stored the variant in a scoreboard. So if it would summon a horse now and would run this, the variant would get stored into the scoreboard. So let's kill it again, let's clear it, let's summon a new horse and make data get entity. So here you can see here's a variant tag which is variant 2, and this variant 2 would get stored into the scoreboard. So we also could make like data modify entity, that entity, and then we would could change the variant. So what, oh, it's sorry, So, now it works. So, you can see we could like change the variant of that horse. It would still be the same horse, but just change texture. But the original score would always get stored here because I only do it one time. So if you would like tag remove, it would like get reloaded. So yeah, basically I do that. So what we could do with that is we could summon a whole bunch of horses, and every horse on the world would get its variant stored. So now to the bug. The bug is actually pretty stupid, because now we could basically, as an example, we could make execute as every horse, and then with the scores of horse variant, and then say like 774 run say hi. So now there's only one horse with that variant. Now we could could say hi, but let's just summon a new horse to better demonstrate it. So that one would be 6. So you would see it always says hi. But now to the problem. If we would go to the nether dimension and then would teleport the exact same horse into the nether, it isn't in the score anymore. And if we type the command, it also isn't found anymore. But if we would get the data entity, it still says that it is a variant of 6. It's all also everything here is chunk loaded, so don't wonder about that. So kill yours again. Is it dead? It should be dead. It isn't dead. Maybe force load didn't work. It should be dead. Or maybe that's the same bug. I don't know. It should be dead. So yeah, basically that doesn't work. So there actually is a workaround for that, which I found out together with Plagiatus, or Plagiatus as you want to call it, as you want to call him, not it. So basically the workaround is not that simple, but I think it also needed to be done, even if you like the score wasn't an option, no time options. So summon a horse, and what we now could do is basically we could give the horse an dirt block or some other item in the hand items slot, because a horse of course doesn't render something in the hand, so it's completely pointless to do it, you would think, but it isn't. You could not do it like in the armor items, because you actually would give the horse some armor items. If, as an example, you would give it diamond horse armor, so that's not an option. It would be an option if you would store it in the right position, but just use hand items. And then you basically, what you could do is you could store the complete MBT of that horse in the hand item, in the tag, in the, like, call it what you want, I called it horse, and now you would store its complete MBT, like you would copy the complete MBT and save it in the horse itself again, in the item of the horse. So let's demonstrate that. If we would, I clear the chat, so if we would get data get entity, if we would get the entity data, you see that's everything that is in the horse. Let's clear it again. And if you would activate that and then would get the data entity, you would see it is twice as large. That's because if we would look here is hand items, Minecraft dirt, and in the dirt, here you see horse brain memories, and here is like the exact complete same MBT. So everything is stored. Here's the variant, and up here Let me check where it is. Can't find it right now. It's somewhere here. It should be somewhere here. I can see it, but it should be there. It's... I'm not lying. I swear to God, I'm not lying. It's here. It should be here. You probably saw it, but I don't see it. But you should see it. It's there. I'm just blind, and I really want to find it. Where is it here? Variant? It's next to armor drop chances? Oh, maybe it's... Maybe it's down here. Yeah, it's down here, because here... Here's the variant, and here's the variant again. Because it's behind hand drop items, so... It's like... somewhere here is the MBT, which counts to the other MBT, because hand items is... Not the last in the line. So here's variant 4, here's variant 4. So what we then could do... Is we could... delete specific things out of the hand items, like the dimension information, the saddle item, the armor items, and the position. So you would see somewhere here is stored the position. Can't find it, but it's you know the drill. It's there. Yeah, it's somewhere here. Somewhere here is the position, and basically, yeah, I saw it here. Here it is. Here's the position. And if you would type that, clear it again, get the data again, it isn't here anymore. So we could delete specific things we don't need, like position, saddle items, armor items, and way more. Could delete that out of the hand items. And on a later point, I don't have a comment block for that, but you get the idea. So you could later save... store the complete MBT out of the item MBT back into the normal MBT, and then you basically could like clear the dirt block, so replace it with air, and then the MBT would be completely gone. So you could do that. So now you would have a workaround, because you could actually test for that in the Nether, but it doesn't work with scores, and I really need that to be fixed. I mean, I've found a workaround, but I still think that needs to be fixed. So I apologize for my bad sounding, but my teeth really hurt because, yeah, don't know what it's called in English, but you know it, that really frustrating thing you get in, yeah, in your mouth, which like really hurts, and sometimes you need to go to the doctor, and they just like, yeah, redo it, and yeah. So, sorry again for that, and it's really late, and I'm really nervous right now, but hope it wasn't that terrible, and hope you understood something out of it. So, yeah, see you in the next video, bye-bye, and yeah, hope this gets fixed, bye.